Welcome to the Voice of the Lord. Our verse for today is in Isaiah 29, verse 13. The Lord says, "These people come near to me with their mouth and honor me with their lips, but their hearts are far from me. Their worship of me is made up only of rules taught by men." Whenever we come before the Lord, do we come with our mouth only and lips that will glorify Him, and yet these are not from our hearts? Friends, the Lord wants us to worship Him not just by our lips only, but more especially that we may worship Him from our hearts. Let the lips declare what is in our hearts. Amen. Let our love for the Lord overflow in our hearts so that the lips will utter it, and that will be pleasing before God. But if only we offer a lip service to God, then that's not pleasing before Him, because the heart is far from Him. So whenever we come to offer our prayers, our song, our worship, our thanksgiving, friends, let all this be from our hearts. Hallelujah. Amen. And these are to please God and not to please men. The reason why we often go before God, though our heart is far from Him, and offer those praises and worship, is to please men. We pretend, friends, that we are close to God when we are actually not close to God, when we don't even listen to Him, we don't even spend time with Him. And yet, before the eyes of men, as if we are so close to God, because we come with our mouth and lips declaring our praises, yet those praises are not the overflow of a loving heart. Amen. And we can only worship the Lord acceptably, friends, if we love Him, if we love the Lord, if we have Him in our lives. If we love the Lord, friends, then there is an overflow of love from our hearts, and then we utter words that will glorify Him. Amen. So that, yes, even our songs, our prayers, our worship will be pleasing before Him. Amen. So friends, let's guard our hearts. Every time that we go and stand before the presence of God, let us be conscious, friends, that He knows what's in our hearts, that we cannot fool the Lord. Hallelujah. Yes, we can fool people around. We can pretend that we are worshiping the Lord before the eyes of people around that are watching us. But we cannot fool God. So why don't we go before God with a sincere heart, saying that, "Lord, today I'm so far from You because of sin. Lord, forgive me, Father, that I may come close to You, so that when I praise You, then I can lift up holy hands before You, that my praise will be acceptable before You." See, that should be the attitude of our hearts, friends, if we feel that we are far from God. And if we feel that we have sinned, and if we are not even worthy to stand before God, don't say to yourself, friends, that you should not come to church, that you should not go to our worship service because you are not worthy. Friends, that is not the right attitude. The more that you draw close to God when we have sinned. Amen. When we have sinned, friends, the more that we draw close to God and ask for forgiveness, for us to detach ourselves from Him, to stay away from Him, friends, that is the wrong way of worshiping and serving God. Now, let's humble ourselves before Him today, friends. If your heart is not right, come before the Lord. Amen. And ask, "Don't forgive me, Lord. And Lord, fill my heart with love, love towards You. Fill my heart with joy. And may I be able to utter the joy that comes from my heart." So that should be your desire. Hallelujah. So friends, let us worship the Lord together. Let us offer praises coming from a loving heart. May the Lord continue to just search our hearts, friends, and reveal unto us the things that we ought to repent of, that we may ask God to forgive us now, that we can offer to Him the right praise and worship. Then we shall not be worshiping the Lord following rules taught by human beings, by mere men. Then we can follow and worship the Lord, friends, using ways that have been prescribed to us in the scriptures. Amen. So let's continue to read the Bible. Then we may know how to worship the Lord properly. Hallelujah. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May His face shine upon you and be gracious unto you and lift up His countenance on you and give you His peace, His shalom. God bless. See you again next time. Bye.